life.
Whoa.
We had an amazing meeting that was like unbelievably long. 3 hours to be exact. You won't believe the time. It's 2:21 a.m. I just closed my computer. Look at the madness. So, this is a computer that I had in the garage. An old school Dell. And by old school, maybe not this one. Sorry. That one. Like 5 years old. That is like my server now, okay? Then I have my Dell laptop that I use. I would say that's like my main thing that I use to work around the house when I can't be down here in my lair. When like being a mom. Or if I need to work like at Starbucks or something, I take that Dell. The Mac, which I still can't get married to the Mac Pro. Awesome. I just think that I'm stuck in a PC world. Then I have my main Dell with my screenage, which is where when I can. I do a lot of work. The moral of that story is, I think I have things figured out electronic wise. I need to, so you can say that the Mac is more for like, when I do YouTube work for other people, I edit on the Mac. It's the weirdest thing. And then, what else do I do on the Mac? Some other applications. And I'm sure once we open our business, like for point of sale and things like that, I'll use a Mac. But yeah, I'm pretty much a PC. I'm committed. I'm a PC. Kind of. Anyway, I'm delirious. I need to go to bed. I need to just be me. When are these pimples going to go away? They're not pimples now because I picked them and now they're blemishes. You think I would learn about messing with my face? If I see a pimple or blackhead, I pop it and I leave these heinous scars that take forever to go away. I need to buy some more Neosporin. I lather Neosporin over my face to make the scars go away. Good night, guys. I'm blabbering.
How are you?
And know what I woke up to? Poop. From this one. Are these a...
Hi.
I woke up to poop. On my floor. From a baby. So, my sister and my niece are here. My brother should be here today sometime. They're moving down.
Mom, no.
Oh my gosh.
Mom, what is?
My Prego sister-in-law wanted some ice cream. So, that's where we are. Hi.
If you ain't your mama's child.
Vlogging. Vlogging. Vlogging.
Okay, what size?
Yeah, you still choosing the amount of ice cream.
Where do you see it say sherbert?
Free. I have my own thing to do. We come to work and play all day.
That's a tip song, apparently. I got watermelon sorbet. Kayla, what'd you get?
Mint. Chocolate chips and roasted almonds.
You're gonna eat all that.
I know.
Do you not want to be on the vlog?
Huh?
Do you not want to be on the vlog?
Thanks.
I won't show your face. Hold your phone out. What'd you get?
Sweet cream with cookie dough, Heath bar, and brownie.
Look at this height issue. It's a real thing. Yeah. Are you really gonna eat all that? Why? If you tilt it like this.
Did you get napkins?
You need some. That's a lot.
That's a lot of ice cream.
Why are you holding your spoon like a barbarian?
It's a barbarian.
Someone who does not hold the spoon correctly? There you go. Get some napkins. That looks just like Ethan's cake a couple years ago. What's his name? That kid.
Did you say thing.
Ethan, come get your shoes on. Where's your shoes? You need... Come get shoes.
But I gotta poop
ball. Ethan!
Zion, come!
He's like, but I gotta take a dump.
That's what he's looking
he's
for.
He's so down. He's so down. He's like, wait.
Ew.
Can I get another bag?
Yeah. Mommy, why are you videoing that?
Ew.
That's pretty gross. Can I get another bag?
This is why I'm no longer a dog owner. Doesn't he need to, like, to wipe his butt?
The dog. Dogs don't. In the wild, when would they wipe their butts?
So I know plenty of people who wipe their dogs.
Yeah, and that's them.
Just wait.
Dogs, Ethan!
Butts are not
shoes!
Meant to be wiped.
Shoes! Ethan!
His hair was still there.
Ethan! Shoes! Kayla, get him. Fast. Come on, get your shoes on. Take him to get some shoes on.
Can you hold this?
Yeah, I have to go to a meeting real quick. But we're going to be ready to go at 3. It's me. It's always on time. My brother. Who comes to someone's house and parks in the middle of the monthly driveway? Who does that? Oh, sorry. My brother. That's who. Crap. It's hot. So, I have a meeting right now. Then, my sister-in-law's sister lives here as well, so she's out with her. Anyway, so after my meeting, we will go. To another meeting, and then to the pool. Take my brother and sister out. Oh my gosh, it's hot. It's a beautiful summer day. Had a great yoga. It's nothing like yoga from your teacher. My teacher Leanne was back in town. So I had a fantastic 75 minute crazy powerful practice on the endo board.
And practicing on the endo board makes me feel like summer. Like I'm actually surfing or something. And it causes me to be more present because instead of like trying to do something new, I'm like so intentional about where I am. And it's pretty awesome. And then I got out of class to some great news that my sister Joy has lost 50 pounds. And my mom is down 60 pounds. I'm just so proud of my family members. I'm like elated. And it's just so funny. I was thinking about it, how for years, I've been trying to get my family in shape. And I'm like, I can even remember when I was 16 and I became a vegetarian and I was really trying to promote health in my family. And I saw that there was, you know, an issue there and trying to get people more active. But what has changed in this last year that made my family members, and I'm not trying to take all the credit by any means, but it's one thing to tell people something and it's a whole nother thing to show them. And I know and I've heard from them also, like they've seen my commitment to my practice, to even like teaching yoga and doing the nutrition challenge, which I'm ready to do again. They've seen my commitment and it inspired them. So your actions and the life you live is much more impactful than any words you say, any books you recommend, anything else. Like, I have the ability to affect change by improving myself. And that's just like, that is the nutshell of epiphany right there that I'm so proud of. I'm proud of myself for being an example. I'm proud of them for taking their power back. And I just look forward to like doing that for more people. That's part of what this blog is. Like, I want y'all to see my life and see like, oh, it is possible. Like, here's this 30-year-old Christian mom who, it's great to live this life. And it's not living Dana's life, it's live your own life. And I hope that you're drawing inspiration. Like, I'm not perfect all the time. I'm not perfect any of the time. I'm imperfectly perfect in myself. That's like a message right there. That's like a sermon. Anyway. So this meeting I'm going to now is about church and how we can improve our early learners, our early friends. What's the temperature? It says 85, but geez Louise, it feels hotter than that. We're back at the pool and my niece and brother and sister-in-law. It's so perfect out. It's perfect pool weather. Summer loving, having some fun. Let's see if we can spot my kids. Oh, there's David. Ethan's been messing with my camera, so it's like, even I look like super bright. I don't know what's going on. I just got my hair braided. I don't know what's going on with the exposure. And now I'm like, oh my god. All the seafood sensation to get some food. I'm teaching yoga at church tonight. Super busy. My brother and sister-in-law and niece went to the beach to meet up with my other sister and her family, the beach in Alabama. And we just, 7-hour drive, like we just did that road trip to Orlando. I'm not trying to road trip with kids. And we have friends coming in town next week and my other sister coming in town next week as well. So I don't feel like going to that. Anyway, especially since Chris and I are going to, we're going to Mexico later in the summer anyway.
So.
All right, now I'm at church. This is the dance room at church where I teach yoga. And at the hair braiding, the African hair braiding place, she gave me some tranquility massaging oil from Africa. All the way from Africa. And the proceeds go to support sending young African girls to school there. I wish you could, I need to put some of this massage oil on my legs. I don't know if you can see how ashy
I am.
I need a pedicure. It smells good. It has lavender in it and stuff. But yeah, with it being the day before the holiday, I don't know how many people are coming. I'm gonna practice a little bit until somebody, if anybody shows up. Can you see from here?